John Bollinger with Premier Guitar. Today we're doing a review demo of the Valvetrain ThunderTrain. I'll tell you all about this very cool guitar after a very cool amp, rather, after I tell you about how I'm recording it. This is my Les Paul standard. It's got DiMarzio PAFs on a B bender. Other than that, pretty much stock. I'm running a Klotz cable directly into this bad boy, and it's running into a Valvetrain cabinet, 212 cabinet that has two Weber speakers in them. This is my personal cabinet. I'm not really sure what the speakers are anymore because I've had it for a long time, but you get the idea. 212s. Miking it with a Royer R121 that's going in an Apogee Quartet and the Pro Tools. So guitar, amp, Pro Tools. Later on, I'll be playing my old Strat so you can see what it does with single coils. But for right now, let's see what it does in humbucker land. So the ThunderTrain is a 35-watt American-made hand-wired tube amplifier that was inspired by the Supro or Valco Thunderbolt from the mid-60s. Those are great amps that have been kind of coveted but are hard to find today. And if you can find them, they're kind of old and cranky. So what they did at Valvetrain is took the best ingredients of that and then added some very cool bits to it. Some of those cool bits include this magic switch in back that gets you from 35 watts at the pentode rating to a 17 watt at the triode setting. I came in on the 35 watts because I think it sounds a little better, and I know our demographic. They like loud, raucous amps, and this does all of that. So another very cool upgrade from those old classic vintage amps is this happy little fellow right here, the Governor. What the Governor is a output manager. Essentially, okay, right now it's a 35 watt amp, and this is a loud, like play an arena type 35 watts. It's loud and pretty punishing, particularly when you've got, as I had it, I've got it dimed everywhere else. Tones all the way up, volumes all the way up, bright switches on, and it's a killer tone. But without that Governor on, I'll just do it for a second because I can't torture myself and Perry like that. But here goes. Now that might have been overriding our input. I don't know, but it's loud, man. But the great thing about this, you can kind of put it wherever you want and you still get all that nuance and magic of a dimed amp without the volume. So, you know, you can just really work your volume. Bring it all the way up there, turn the Governor all the way up, and it's really reasonable. That's when, you know, you got the spouse watching TV and kid trying to sleep, you're not gonna bug them like that. So you're rocking away, they don't even know you're there, provided your room is somewhat, you know, isolated. Anyway, that's a great feature. Now, in back here, let me just put this on standby and then switch it to the other mode, which is gonna cut your power in half. So I'll take the Governor, or actually, cut it down to 17 watts. So here we are with the Governor off in the other mode. Whoops, there we go. So another great option, so you can get that full, without the Governor, because there is actually, I hear a little bit of a tone change when the Governor is engaged, but tone and volume are so closely connected, it's hard to say which is which. But taking the Governor off and switching the wattage in back is a great option as well. Now, why don't we try a Strat so you can see what it does with some single coils. Okay, now we're in single coil land with my old 55 Strat, and the thing I love about this amp is you really get the character of the guitar. You know, I mean, you know. You know that's a Strat. I mean, you can really kind of hear that. It's just a great way to get that tone across. And I think one of the reasons this is such a great sounding amp, they really went to painstaking details to get that classic tone. One thing they did, the transformers are manufactured to the original blueprints by the same factory and even the same winding machine as the original 60s Valco parts. So, I mean, that's when you really care. You go to the trouble to actually get the same thing. You know, and I don't know, when you hear a great amp, there's so many factors involved, you can't really say it's this or this. It's probably a little combination of all of it. But this is just a great sounding American rock and roll amp. Other ingredients contributing to this tone, of course, are the two preamps, the 12AX7s, the Match 5881 duet power tubes, and the rectifier is a 5AR4/GZ34. Now that doesn't mean a lot to me, but I'm sure you true amp nerds out there are thinking, oh yeah, I love that. Anyway, I'll tell you what, to read the full written review, go to premierguitar.com. While you're online, make sure you like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, check us out on Instagram, Twitter, all that jazz. Maybe have the hard copy sent right to your home. This is John Bolger. Till next time.
Don't forget to sign up for PG Perks, your all-access pass to exclusive gear giveaways and discounts on PremierGuitar.com.